We could all use some healing these days, so we turn to the power of music. Each Monday, we welcome another artist to share some songs and stories as the Nicole Sandler Show presents the Monday Music Sunset Sessions.
All right, I'm back, and in just a moment, we'll be joined by Dan Bern. It's so funny, I was getting his shot all set up during the Labor History in Two, and I have him up on the screen, and I just saw him walk out of the room. So he's there. Dan Bern will be back with us shortly. Hopefully he's just grabbing some water or something. But let me tell you a little bit about Dan Bern while we're waiting for him to come back. He is a modern-day troubadour. Dan Bern has been writing, recording, and performing songs for a few decades now. Having released something on the order of 25 albums and EPs, he's played thousands of live shows across North America and Europe. And now, thanks to, well, the COVID and quarantining, he's doing it on the internet with a series of Hunkered in the Bunker webcasts. Dan Bern, there you are. Thank you so much for joining us for this. It's so nice to see you again.
Oh, it's a pleasure to see you.
I don't know if you even remember me, but we met back in 1997 when your first CD came out. I actually still have it right here. It's called Dog Boy Van. This was just an EP before your major label debut came out on Work Records. By the way, Pam Edwards says hello, if that name rings
great
a bell.
Sure.
And I was fortunate enough to work at a very cool radio station in L.A. at the time that played your music. And I've been a fan of yours ever since. And there you are. So thank you for being here. So
thank you for having me, and thanks for doing what you're doing.
Oh, it's my pleasure. You know, I've been doing talk radio for some years now, but as I remind listeners all the time, we need something other than the news and politics, because that'll make you crazy. And music has been my saving grace. Music is what pulled me out of the depression that I fell into after Trump got elected. And it's my escape from the world, and I think we all need it. As a songwriter, do you feed off of what happens in the world, or do you just make up stories as you go along?
Oh, definitely. I mean, I've always taken the political very personally. So I never put a barrier between, you know, political songs and personal songs. It's all what affects you.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, right now, there's a lot to affect you.
There is. You also have a wealth of material to choose from throughout the years, but you're still writing. In fact, you've got a new record of quarantine-related music, an album called Quarantine Me, that I guess you recorded and released during our time staying at home, trying to stay safe.
Yeah, I mean, that one already feels old to me.
Because
that was like the first probably month of the whole quarantine thing. So, I mean, so much has happened since. I mean, we're moving in some warp speed. And so I'm always more concerned about what's sort of, you know, what I'm doing right now and what's coming up. And even what I did 4 months ago, 3 months ago, feels old. That's why I think I had trouble when I was with, you know, a big record company and they wanted to focus on something for a long time.
Hmm.
And I was moving too fast, I think, to be able to really support something, one thing for that long.
Right, because they do. They run it into the ground, much like radio runs songs into the popular radio, runs songs into the ground, where they play them over and over again to the point where it's like, I don't ever want to hear that again. But Dan Bern is with us. You've consented to give us a taste of what you do on your Hunkered in the Bunker shows here on Facebook Live and play a couple songs for us. So what are you going to start with?
Well, I got this one out. I'm sort of going between, you know, being in one place and having all my old songbooks at the reach.
Mm.
And sort of unusual position for me of being able to play anything that I've, you know, that I've ever done. So that really widens that bag. Plus, I'm also writing a ton because, as we were saying, there's so much to sort of play off of. And then I'm also learning a lot of, you know, other people's songs, which, again, is easy if it's sitting in front of you. Uh-huh. So that really widens the whole palette. Plus, I got my daughter Lulu, who comes in from time to time. She sings songs.
I've seen her on a couple of them.
Yeah.
Very sweet. So keep it in the family.
Well, like a lot of people, you know, you're looking for some hope and some feeling of hope and belief and energy, positive. A lot of times, I got to admit, sometimes the only times I feel that is when I'm actually singing, you know, actually playing and singing. And then it's like, I feel like I'm walking 10 feet above everything and, you know, just floating along blissfully or whatever it is, angrily or, you know,
frustratedly. Right.
So I play and sing as much as I possibly can right now.
Right. So what do you want to do for us first?
This one's called George Floyd.
Ah.
I just, you know, felt like in the tradition of those songs, like that we remember something, you know, so that, yeah. One night in Minneapolis on the 25th of May, in a time of upheaval and in a time of plague, in a time of doubt and trouble, be afraid of where you breathe. Doctors, nurses dying, and ain't it something to believe? A man was taken to the ground, you can see the picture still, for the crime of buying cigarettes with a fake $20 bill. And a knee to his neck, 8:46, I kid you not. He pleaded, cried, I can't breathe. And to his dead ma, he called out, George Floyd, George Floyd, you did not die in vain. Good people rising up in your name. Pictures spread like fire, and the images they burn across the land like a volcano. Could learn to do some business like usual, where darkness is a crime in a country and society where it happens all the time. But somehow this was different, it was more of the same, at a time when love was needed, just more nonsense and more shame. And the world took notice, and the world took to the streets, and the world echoed, I can't breathe, the world rose to its feet. George Floyd, George Floyd, you did not die in vain. Good people rising up in your name. And with masks to our faces, 'cause the plague it didn't stop, we rose up with fury against the violence and the cops, and the call rang out for justice across a stricken land. But the fascists call for more blood, the fascists tip their hand. But even with the armies of the fascists cracking heads, something real was growing through the concrete and lead. You did not ask for martyrdom, you can't get back what they stole, but there ain't no weapon ever made that can rob you of yours. So, George Floyd, George Floyd, you did not die in vain. Good people rising up in your name. George Floyd, George Floyd, you did not die in vain. Good people rising up in your name.
Dan Bern, George Floyd. Wow. Thank you for writing that. That's important. And I bemoan often the lack of good new protest music. Do you think there's a lack of it, or are we just not hearing it, that it's out there?
I think it's pretty much out there. You know, again, whether it's going to be that 5-8 times a day pop song on the radio, no, it comes from underneath, you know, it comes from the basement.
Right.
And most of the time, I think it's like that, you know. You know, Bob Dylan in 1965 was kind of an exception, I think. But it's all over and splintered, and there's no one. It's like, you know, it's up to everybody in their little ways.
That it is. You mentioned Bob Dylan, and you've been compared to Bob Dylan a lot over the years, and it could be the, you know, the voice, it could be the artistry in your lyrics, it could be the a lot of things. I mean, do you see a comparison there, or does it bother you? You're a better tennis player.
Much better tennis player than him.
Gotcha.
They never say that.
Okay. Well, because that's not on display for all of us to see regularly.
Well, I'm just telling you, Nicole. I'm just telling
Good
you.
Good to know.
It used to bug me, I think, a little bit. At first it was flattering, then it used to bug me. Now it's back to, yeah, sure.
Right. Have you met him?
I've not met him, no.
Have you met Bruce Springsteen?
I have, yeah.
Well, and did he know about your song in which you meet Bruce Springsteen?
Yeah, he did know about it. I don't know that he had heard it. And if I had been a little more on my game, I would have immediately called for a guitar and played it to him right away.
Uh-huh.
But at least he knew about it. And he, you know, all the stories about him are true. He's super gracious and remembers everybody and the whole thing.
Yeah, I met him once too, and I was about what I was able to get out, but it was when that radio station, when we played your music in Los Angeles, had just gone on the air, and he and Patty were together, and she's like, "Oh, Bruce, she's at that radio station that we love," and he's, "Oh, I love that station. We listen all the time." So that of course happened, all, you know, 25 years ago, and will remain with me forever. You are not only a musical artist, but you're a visual artist as well, Dan Bern. You do cool drawings and little videos that we could see on Facebook. You actually had an art show last year, didn't you? And if you say, I guess you were down here in South Florida. I didn't even know.
I did one in Isla Mirada, and then I did one in New York, and I did a baseball one in with songs in San Francisco, and a tennis one.
Wow.
I got a picture. I just did this one of John Lewis yesterday.
Oh, that's awesome. If not says, us, then who?
Can you see what it says?
It says, if not us, then who? Around. If not now, then when? John Lewis. That's wonderful. That's great.
I like to do all that stuff.
Have you ever released a book or anything of your artwork? I know you did a book of poetry, but have you done a book of your art, of your drawing art?
Not a book of one as such. If I've done a bunch of books and there's drawings in those. I recently discovered this coolest app in the world called Flip-A-Clip, and it allows you to make cartoons. So I've been making cartoons.
Oh, really?
Just my daughter Lulu taught me this app, and so it's just in the last couple of weeks, it's kind of like this amazing thing. Mark Maron, he,
yeah,
at the end of all his shows, he plays little blues licks, right?
Mm-hmm.
He grabs his guitar and he's in his garage. So he plays some electric guitar. And then at the very, very end, he yells, "Boomer Lives." That's his little trademark. Boomer was his cat who disappeared.
Right.
So it's like Boomer Lives. And I thought, oh, Maron's—he's playing all this cool sounding guitar, and he's got this Boomer Lives kind of chorus. It's like, that's his song, but he only does it once, and he doesn't do it while he's playing. So I grab those two bits and loop the Boomer Lives, so he's doing it while he's playing. And it was like a 30-second clip, and then I made a cartoon, and I just put it up on Twitter, and he saw it, and he retweeted it, and it's like, so suddenly tons of people saw this thing that, you know, just very, very fast the way this stuff works sometimes now.
Technology is a blessing and a curse, I think. Look, it's allowed us to come together during this pandemic when we're all stuck at home. I've done a number of things, including starting this Monday music segment. But I also did a thing where I was calling all over the world to people shut in other countries, all quarantining together. I think this is the first time on a global scale we've all been experiencing the same kind of very strange reality, and that is staying at home to avoid getting this horrible virus that's killing a lot of people. And so it's made this very big world a little bit smaller. It's also made people like you, Dan Bern, who are troubadours, who spend a lot of time on the road performing, have to find a new way to get your music out there and to hopefully make a few dollars. So you have been doing these hunkered in the bunker sessions on Facebook Live and asking people, they can help you out by donating to your Venmo or I guess PayPal or whoever. And a lot of artists are turning to this. So how long have you been doing these now?
Just since this started, like almost immediately.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever that is, like or mid-March probably might have been the first one.
Gotcha. And you get very interactive. I mean, are you finding it's fostering a relationship between you and your fans?
Absolutely. I mean, I feel, you know, I miss the crawl when I don't see the crawl. You know, the crawl of comments.
Right.
It's like, if that's not there, it's like, who am I talking to?
Gotcha. I guess it'll be weird when you hit back a stage and the, you won't have the ticker going along. But then you get the applause, which I'm sure is it weird performing without that immediate audience feedback in that manner? You do get it from the comments.
Well, you... It's almost like those, now you get those thought bubbles, like in those, you know, they'll do that in those movies sometimes. You know, it used to be somebody would come up to you after the show maybe and say, I really was hoping you'd play blah, 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 blah. And you're like, well, okay, I'll play it tomorrow in some other town. But now you get it immediately.
Right.
And, you know, you're doing some other song and they're talking about something else. And then they start talking to each other. And it's definitely a different thing. I mean, it's not being in a room full of live people. It's, no. You know, it's not that, but it's a different thing. It's just
a new experience. Right. Yeah. Can we get you to do another song for us?
Sure. Lulu just crept in here. So
yeah.
Maybe we'll do one together.
Okay. How old is Lulu?
Lulu just turned 11.
Wow.
You can't hear them right now. I can hear them. I can hear Nicole. I'm talking to Nicole. Come on in.
Hi, Lulu.
Just turned 11. Say hi.
Hi. Hi. She's adorable.
Maybe we'll do it a little higher. Should we do it a little higher? When Jackie Robinson pulled that uniform on, when Jackie Robinson pulled that jersey on, his eye was clear and his voice rang true, and the number on his back was 42. 42.
42. 42. 42.
The number on his back was 42, 42,
42,
42. The number on his back was 42. Born in Georgia, played in Negro leagues,
army green in the big war overseas. Then the big leagues come a-calling, said Mr. Robinson, pull this off. And the number on his back was 42.
Trumpet.
When Jackie Robinson pulled that jersey off, his eye was clear and his voice rang true. The number on his back was 42. Born in Georgia, switched to army green in the big war. Come calling, said Mr. Robinson, pull this off. And the number on his back was 42.
Here we go.
42. The number on his back was 42. 42. 42. Number on his back was 42. Born in Georgia, played in the Negro Leagues, switched to army green in the big war overseas. Then the big leagues come a-calling, said Mr. Robinson, pull this off. And the number on his back was 42.
One more time, 42.
42.
42.
The number on his back was 42. 42. 42. He wore Dodger blue and every color of the rainbow too. 42. 42.
Want to take us out with that horn?
That was awesome. 42. Dan Bern and Lulu. And what, just playing a trumpet a mouthpiece there? What was that?
That was the All-American Kazoo.
Oh, it was a kazoo. I
but,
love
you
it.
You know, if you play it right, it sounds like a flugelhorn.
Something like that. That was wonderful. You know, 42, of course. You do have a whole album of baseball songs. Obviously, you're a big baseball fan.
Yeah, I love it, and I love the lore of the game. I grew up reading a lot about it because where I grew up, we didn't have a major league team, so I kind of always came to it that way and through songs. And then finally, when I was, a very young man, I was in Chicago. So I went to Wrigley Field every day. And then that's a great place to hang out.
I've not been. I've been to Yankee Stadium and the old Shea Stadium and Fenway Park.
Got you up to Fenway? You got up to Fenway?
I've been to Fenway. I programmed the river in Boston for a while.
Oh,
and so
sure.
I got to see Springsteen at Fenway, which that was, I never saw a baseball game at Fenway, but I saw Bruce at Fenway. So that made my baseball
yeah,
career.
Work.
It worked. It was awesome. So Dan Bern, I know you with a guitar in hand, but in 2018, you lost two fingers in a snowblower accident. What happened?
Well, that makes it sound a little more dramatic than it was. I lost the ends of a couple of fingers. I lost that much of my middle finger.
Yeah.
And then I lost some of my pointer. It took a while, but I started playing the piano in that time when I couldn't play the guitar. So, you know, blessings come along with everything.
You
and
do,
I got lucky because I can play the guitar again. So
that's awesome.
Yeah.
And you did you had an album out a couple of years ago that, and I can't remember the name of it. Sorry, what was your last studio album?
It was called Regent Street.
Regent Street, and so when this pandemic is over, you pick up and go back on the road, or you think this will change how you do business in the future?
Yeah, I have no idea.
None of us
do. I have no idea. I mean, I can imagine that even if I'm traveling, I might still be doing, these shows in this format too. And who knows what else? I mean, it's kind of just the beginning, and everything got a little sped up. But I think making predictions right now is real hard.
Yeah. It, definitely, because who knows what's going to happen? We've got all these benchmarks coming up. We have November 3rd coming up, but then we have January 20th coming up. We don't know what's going to happen. And then there's the virus on top of it all. So, we just, I guess, have to wait and see try to stay sane in the meantime. So before we leave, we're coming up on the end of the hour, and Progressive Voices Network is going to leave us right at the top of the hour. So I want to make sure people know where they can find you. Dan Bern, BERN.com is your website. Through there, but they can find you have an online radio station, Radio Free Bernstein, which I can't get because I don't have a Mac. So I think it only streams.
You should be able to get it on your phone, too.
Oh, really? On my Android? I have an Android.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll have to check it out because I couldn't get it on my computer. I'm a PC person. You also host a podcast. You're still doing that, 10,000 Crappy Songs?
I'm waiting. We did season one. Season two's already, except the guy who's my musical partner in that, Will Massasak from the old IJBC, all his stuff is locked away somewhere that he's not. So, but season two hopefully will be out soon. That's fun. A guy who wrote 10,000 crappy songs by his own estimation, and then gives it up and becomes a detective, and circumstances always force him to write some song to further his case.
Awesome. As every detective should. You can find all that at danbern.com. Of course, find Dan Bern on Facebook Live when he does his Hunkered in the Bunker, and tons of 25 or so albums that you can choose from. So go check out Dan Bern. Can I get you to do one more song on the way out?
Sure. Anything you want to hear?
Can I get you to do Jerusalem if you want to go all the way back?
Let's do it.
All right. Dan Bern.
When I tell you that I love you, don't test my love, accept my love, don't test my love. 'Cause maybe I don't love you all that much. Don't ask what kind of music I'm gonna play tonight. Just stay a while, here for yourself a while. And if you must put me in a box, make sure it's a big box with lots of windows and a door to walk through. And a nice hot chimney, so we can burn everything. We don't like to watch the ashes fly up to heaven, maybe all the way to India. I'd like that. All the ancient kings came to my door. They said, you want to be an ancient king too? I said, oh yes, very much, but I think my timing's wrong. They said, time is relative. Heard it in mystery Einstein. I said, do you really need it? They said, what do you think we come here for? A goddamn help or something? Everybody's waiting for the Messiah, the
Jews are waiting, Christians are waiting, also the Muslims. It's like everybody's waiting. They've been waiting a long time. I know how I hate to wait, like even for a bus or something, an important phone call. So I can just imagine the darned impatience everybody must be getting. So I think it's time now, time to reveal myself. I am the Messiah. I am the Messiah. I am the Messiah. Ooh. Yeah, I think you heard me right. I am the Messiah. I was gonna wait till next year, build up the suspense a little, make it a really big surprise, but I could not resist. It's like when you got a really big secret, you're just bursting to tell someone. It was sort of like that with this. And now that I've told you, I feel this great weight lifted. Dr. Nussbaum was right. He's my therapist. He said, get it out in the open. I spent 10 whole days in Jerusalem. Jerusalem. Sweet Jerusalem. And all I ate was olives. Nothing but olives. Mountains of olives. It was a good 10 days. I like olives. I like you too. So when I tell you that I love you, don't test my love. Accept my love. Don't test my love. Cause maybe if I don't love you all that.
Yes, there's the applause. Dan Bern, thank you so much. This is awesome. The only downside is, you know, a shaky internet connection at times. But this has been such a treat for me. And I know I'm watching the people, you know, in the chat room, and they're loving it, too. Thank you so much for doing this. I really, really appreciate it. And thank you for keeping the music going and entertaining us all while we're all stuck at home. It's a treat watching you.
Well, thanks for doing what you're doing. And, you know, let's do it again anytime.
I would love to. Absolutely. I will take you up on that. Dan Bern, again, check him out at danbern.com. Find him on Facebook. Listen to his albums. Look him up on YouTube. You can see, you know, a lot of performances. They're all over the place. You got a year's worth of great music to choose from. And thanks to you, and thanks to Lulu as well. Thank you, Dan.
All right.
All right.
Thanks,
Nicole. Take care. Bye-bye. What a treat that was. And with that, we are done. That's the end of another day. Tomorrow's Tuesday. Who knows what the hell the day is going to bring us, but we'll cover all the news. Got a Laugh will be here. We'll have some fun, too, and we'll take it from there. Thanks for listening, everyone. Have a good one. See you tomorrow. Bye.